Previously on Dream Team.
Patrick Doyle is the manager. He should have protected me from such disaster. Now I cannot play.
You're saying my wife knows about this?
Yes. Well, I thought that you backed Patrick.
Don't you realise I've been blamed for this by everybody, down to the flipping ball boy?
There's supposed to be trust between a manager and a chairman. I think it's time for us to part company.
You're amazing.
I own you. And you will do anything I say.
Tash.
All right, darling. Mummy's coming. When did Grandad bring you back, eh? I haven't heard a peep out of you all night.
Oh, my God. Wouldn't bother playing Arsenal tomorrow if I were you. Says here you've lost already. There's 6-1 on to beat you. It also says Carl Fletcher's gay. Carl? What is wrong? You've been in a weird mood since last night.
Nothing.
You're not still annoyed with me, are you?
No.
Then what? I thought we said no more secrets.
Look, this is something I've got to sort out myself, okay? Maybe Jeff didn't see us.
Of course he did, he's brought her back.
Natasha, are you up yet? I want a word with you.
Be down in a minute, Dad. Quick, Robbie, you've got to go.
Well, let me stand and talk to him.
No, leave it to me, I know what he's like.
Natasha!
Quick!
Natasha!
Dad, listen.
I mean, Robbie Walsh, what are people going to think?
Look, let's sit down and talk about this calmly, yeah?
I mean...
No, not there. I hope we're sick there yesterday.
It's wrong, Natasha.
I know it looks bad.
Damn right it does. I mean... Totally wrong image. You should be going for hard lad, not family man. Get off the Beckham bandwagon.
What about last night?
What about it?
When you brought Hope back?
I didn't.
Well, who did then?
Right, Fletch.
FM. In this half hour, the story that's been making all the headlines. Just what is going on at Harchester Football Club?
I'm not looking forward to today. My first sacking.
Maybe you should hold off for a while.
No, I need to be decisive.
But, you know, if you're not sure...
I am. And now's the best time. You've seen what they've been saying. It's either me or him. And it ain't gonna be me.
But we're playing Arsenal tomorrow.
Exactly. No one expects us to win. It's the perfect time. Come on, we better go.
Abby, thanks for looking after Hope.
No problem, she's a joy.
I know. When you brought her back...
I didn't, Fletch did.
What did he say?
Nothing, just that you were asleep and he didn't want to wake you. He can be quite considerate sometimes.
Hey, gorgeous.
Are you going to tell me what's going on?
How about you tell me? Complete the following sentence. I was in bed with Jamie Parker's wife because...
It started when Jamie was in hospital. I had so much to cope with. And I was so lonely, Abby. Robbie was brilliant. He made me feel really special.
It's her, innit? This bird you're in love with.
No! No! It was a one-off. Never even thought of Tash like that. Never even fancied her.
So what then?
We fought our feelings for ages. But you saw how Jamie was. In the end, we just couldn't stop ourselves. Do you know what I mean?
You think I wanted to fall for the most famous womanizer in Harchester?
Jamie had a bit of a rep and all. But that's the thing about Robbie. He's just not like that.
The photo shoot went well. We had a few drinks. I should have said no, but oh, you know how it is, Fletch. She was offering it to me on a plate.
What? What, she came onto you?
Yeah.
I did put a stop to it, but he kept pursuing me. He told me he loved me.
So it's serious?
Yeah.
Did you enjoy it?
No way! I wish I'd never done it.
She's got a nerve. Oh, do you reckon she's had others since Jamie's been away?
Dunno. Maybe.
And the worst thing is, I think I've fallen in love with him.
What about Jamie?
I don't know. What am I gonna do, Abby?
Look, Fletch, it will never happen again, I swear to ya. I'm just not interested. What are you gonna do? Fletch!
He's determined to sack you today. I've tried to persuade him, but he won't back down.
We'll have to try harder.
How?
I don't know. But if I'm sacked today, you were ruined tomorrow.
Please, Patrick.
Gaffer, I was... Sorry. It's all right. We're finished.
No, I just wanted to run over tactics for Arsenal before training.
Look, I know you've got some ideas. Why don't you take training? See if they work out in practice.
But it's the biggest game of the season so far.
So?
Cheers, Gaffer.
I've got a couple of people to see here, then I'll be along.
Nice one. Thanks.
Morning, Jax.
How dare you go behind my back?
I'm sorry?
Showing my husband that Mendoza interview. What were you thinking?
Didn't realise it was a secret.
I took that tape for a reason, to avoid any more damage to this club. I did not instruct you to copy that tape, and I certainly didn't instruct you to show it to my husband.
I thought Phil should know.
Is that part of your job description? I don't think so. You're fired.
But you can't!
I just have.
But...
cover the Arsenal game and then I want you out by the end of the week. And you better do a good job of it, otherwise you won't get any references.
Classic.
Here, what's up?
Hola. What's happening? Walked into a door.
Yeah, right.
Was it Tash because of your hair?
I tell you, it was. It was the baby, wasn't it? Huh? Get off! You're not my dad. Bang!
All right, boys.
Easy.
Nice hair, Robbie.
Ouch.
Nice eye, too. You OK?
Fine.
Good, because we're going to try out a new formation for tomorrow. We're going to play five in midfield. I want to use Ryan and Granty as wing-backs. Robbie, work with Ryan and feed into Marcel.
Ryan?
Any problem with that?
No.
Good. Let's get out there, then. Everybody else get changed.
Looks like you'll be babysitting today, mate.
Come on, lads.
When we get out there today, just try this formation. Just make sure the lads are at it, OK?
Yeah, sure, no problem. Yeah.
You really want to play me against Arsenal?
Why not? You can do it.
They don't seem to think so.
Listen, you are good enough. I should know. I'm the coach.
Robbie, it's me again. Can you call me, please? Fletch wouldn't do anything stupid, would he?
He can be quite grown up, you know. Look, I've got to go into work soon. I'll make sure everything's okay. But you've got to sort this out, Tash, for your own sake.
Every team has a dip in form. And most of the time, it's true to say that it's the manager's fault. But whilst I'm subject to the chairman's decisions, after the recent fans' forum, I feel I must stress that I am equally responsible for our recent dismal performance. Guys, I admit it, I mean, I have made mistakes. I know it's hard to believe, but I'm not superhuman.
And what mistakes would those be?
Do you know, Bob, I think I expect too much of people. Stuart Naismith, for instance. He's a good defender, but perhaps he's not quite ready to be a coach yet.
You're saying he's not up to the job?
No, no. No, he will be a great coach. In time. I just worry that I've let him take on too much too soon. It's entirely my fault. I just like to encourage people. In fact, I ought to go training now, actually. See how he's getting on.
Can we join you?
Yeah, sure. Don't you, why not? No secrets here.
You played a double winners with no manager.
We're hardly going to win whether he's here or not.
Maybe, but it's a bit sudden, isn't it?
I've made my decision, Jeff, and you know why. I want Patrick out.
You're the chairman. I'll scout about for some candidates.
A list by the end of the day would be great.
I'll see what I can do.
OK, thank you. Bye.
Sandra, can you get Patrick Doyle up in now, please?
No! Get the ball in the box early. Don't cut back. Deliver it. Cross it when you've got the chance.
Wing backs, it's not your style, Patrick.
Stuart's experimenting.
But for Arsenal?
Oh, don't count on us playing like that tomorrow.
Young Naismith looks good, though.
Yeah, yeah. It's good to see Stuart giving his son a chance. I'm not sure he's quite ready yet, but who comes first? Coach or father?
Patrick, Mr. Wallace wants to see you immediately.
Right. Do you want to come along, guys? Hear what the chairman has to say about tomorrow? Phil's a great bloke. I'm sure he won't mind. Come on.
I'm sorry, Patrick. It's just that... Patrick, sit down.
Phil, I really think that...
Not now, Jackie, please. I've got to do this right.
But...
Jackie! I'm sorry, Patrick.
What's wrong to Tash? Why can't you tell me?
Look, I've sorted it, all right?
That's your way of dealing with things,
Abs,
is it?
Absolutely. Stay out of this, Abs. This is boy stuff.
No, it's not. It involves Tash.
She's lucky she's a bird. I wish she'd get worse than Robbie.
Try and be a bit more understanding. It's hard for her.
She's a slut!
What?
She's a married woman.
Come on, if I've been through what she had...
Whoa! What, you cheat on me?
I didn't say that.
Yeah, you did. Blimey, you're the same, ain't ya?
What's that supposed to mean?
Manipulators, darling.
Is that right?
Yeah. I mean, you turn it on because you know we can't resist. That's how you get what you want.
So, we're all basically prostitutes, then? Sexual favours for personal gain?
No, no, well... Well, it works, doesn't it?
You are unbelievable!
Mr. Chairman, you know Bob from the Chronicle. Alan from the News, Jim from the Echo. Take a seat, Jess. I'm just taking them on a quick guided tour, show how open we are. You don't mind if they sit in the meeting, do you? Now, what did you want to talk about? Tactics for Arsenal, I suppose.
And here we are in the empty Dragons dressing room, which tomorrow we'll see the players preparing to face the double winners. Can the Dragons shoot down the Gunners all-star lineup of Henry, Will Tord, Vieira?
Hi.
I was filming, Nick.
Sorry. Are you all right?
No. I've been fired.
What? Why?
That cow of a woman. She's had her infamy ever since she came back. I don't know why. All I did was try and help Phil.
But you get on with him, don't you?
He's a nice bloke. Unlike his wife.
So why don't you try and talk to him?
What's the point? It's hardly going to go against Jackie.
It's worth a try, though.
Can't do any harm, I suppose. Good job you stopped me. Hardly the most presentable presenter.
Men are suckers for a good cry, though. Everything all right?
Not really.
What are you doing here?
I've left thousands of messages for you. Why haven't you called me back? Did Fletch do that? Poor baby.
Don't.
Got to talk to him, make sure he don't phone Jamie.
No. I've explained, he won't say anything.
What are we going to do, Robbie?
Not now, Tash.
Well, let's go somewhere else.
No, I can't. I've got to sort my hair out.
We'll come round to mine after then, yeah?
Sorry, we're all in the Grange tonight.
Well, when can we talk?
Dunno.
Well, thanks again for coming, guys. I look forward to reading your copy, as always. Cheers.
See ya.
Bye-bye. Bye, mate.
Cheers.
What happened? What did you tell him?
I have just bought me and you some time. He could hardly sack me with half a Fleet Street there, could he?
Thank God.
But it's not going to last. So you do your job and make sure I keep mine. What I'm telling you. I'll make sure that not only your husband, but the entire British press hang you out to dry.
Please, Patrick, I don't know what to do to persuade him.
Well, what do you normally do when you want to get him to do things?
Tara. Afternoon, Patrick.
Geoffrey, I've got a bone to pick with you.
Sounds ominous.
Apparently, the chairman knows that I twice tried to buy the club. I wonder where he heard that.
Beats me.
Cut the crap, Jeff. You're the only one who knew. I thought we were friends.
So did I. Until I found out you cropped a player I had a lot of money in.
Mendoza was nothing to do with me, and you know that.
Maybe he wasn't your signing, but he was my client, and I lost a fortune on him because of you.
So you went running to Phil, telling tales.
Maybe you deserved it.
I'd be careful if I were you, Jeff. Crossing me would be one of the dumbest things you've ever done.
I'm worried, Patrick.
You should be.
In a few weeks' time, Jamie will be doing this for you. Oh, come here.
Oh, Dad.
I know you miss him, but he may be home sooner than you think.
He'll be okay.
What do you normally do when you want to get him to do things?
I shouldn't be telling you this, but...
Are you sure she wasn't joking? It was hard to tell sometimes.
Oh, no. She meant it all right.
What's going on?
There's been some mistake, right? I mean, you're not sacking Tara.
So it's fine for you to sack someone and not me?
Well, that was different. I had good reasons. What are yours?
Tara, could you excuse us? She's disloyal, disorganised, and she flirts with the players.
She virtually ran HUTV while you were away.
Oh, how cosy for the two of you.
What are you on about?
She's the type of girl that likes to sleep her way to the top.
What possible reason have you got to say that?
Come on, Phil. She's all over you.
No, she isn't.
You fancy her, don't you?
This is ridiculous. I'll speak to you later when you've calmed down.
You crawled to my husband behind my back, did you?
I just wanted a fair hearing.
A few tears and a flash of thigh. Won't work with him, you know. He's not the type.
That's what you think.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
No, go on.
No, I didn't mean anything.
Good. Now go and clear your desk.
I've got a job to do first. Unless you want to cover the Arsenal game yourself.
Right, everyone, rooms as follows. Andy and Ian, Danny and Tomo, Marcel and Curtis, Peter and Granty, Stuart and Ryan, Fletch and Robbie. Curfew at 10, you know the drill. No extracurricular activities. How'd it go?
Don't ask. I'll tell you later. Robbie, Fletch, can I grab a quick interview? Two roomies the night before a match?
Yep, sure.
Dad, what am I sharing with you?
Big game tomorrow, son. Get any worries? Want to talk about anything? Can't sleep. I'll be there for you.
Cheers, Dad.
Right, thank you.
I'll see you in a bit.
Rude Hullet.
He's flying over to London tomorrow. Said he'd be happy to come up for a chat.
Rude Hullet? He's interested?
Are you bringing him to the game?
Have you actually sacked Pratchett yet?
Not quite, no. I was going to, but he brought a lot of journalists in tow.
Clever devil.
What do you mean?
He must have known.
Well, he couldn't do. I mean, I only told the missus.
Don't underestimate Pratchett. He has ways of finding things out. Sooner you get rid of the devious git, the better.
You've changed your tune?
Let's just say I've come round to your way of thinking. And I say strike while the iron's hot. Otherwise, it'll all get played out in the press before you've had a chance. Keep control. That's the key.
I'll do it tonight.
I own you, and you will do anything I say. And when I say anything, I mean anything. You do your job and make sure I keep mine. Or I'm telling you. I'll make sure that not only your husband, but the entire British press hang you out to dry. Well, what do you normally do when you want to get him to do things? If I get the sack, you lose everything.
For the viewers, can you explain why you share a room before a big match?
Dunno.
Is it to keep each other out of trouble?
Suppose.
Like getting into fights? How did you get that? So, do you get to choose your roommates?
No.
Sorry to interrupt. You two, now.
If you come back to have another go.
I've come to say that I'm sorry. Very sorry.
Our main aim tomorrow is counter-attack. Tie it at the back, hit them on the break, which is why I've decided to play as 4-4-2.
But Gaffer, in training today...
I wanted to see how you'd play us. But I don't think five across the midfield is the right system.
I disagree.
I'm sorry, Stuart, but my 10 years managerial experience tells me otherwise. Now, to continue.
You're not really going to sack Pratchett, are you?
You want to discuss this now?
I just don't want you to make any rash decisions that are going to backfire. That's what's made me so touchy today.
I can handle it, Jack.
Can you, though? If we beat Arsenal tomorrow, they'll be saying that Pratchett Doyle is a genius. If you've sacked him, you'll look like a fool. The fans and the press, they'll be merciless. I just don't want to see you get hurt again. I'm only thinking of you.
But we've got to win. If we lose or draw, he's out.
Okay. Thanks for tonight. I'll see you tomorrow morning at breakfast, 9 o'clock.
Sorry, I'm not playing.
Your tactics fail, so I'm on the bench.
Hey, it's not my fault Patrick's dropped you.
It's because I'm your son, innit? Sees the name Naismith. Thinks, waste of space. You're an embarrassment, Dad.
Really?
You're a laughing stock. No one listens to you. You haven't got any influence.
No influence? How do you think you got the job?
On merit.
I begged Pratchett to take you on, and if I hadn't agreed to pay your wages, you'd probably be working in a burger bar.
You are?
Forget it.
I'm only here because you paid for me.
I was just trying to help.
I don't want your help. I'm going to succeed on my own.
Yeah, you will, but...
You know what? I really wish you weren't my dad.
He shouldn't be here, Tash.
Got to talk to him, Abby.
I know, but now isn't the time. Pratchett will go spare it.
Robbie, can I have a word about the Dazzle contract?
You shouldn't have come.
Why are you avoiding me? What's going on?
Oi, slapper. What's the matter? Want something off for you? Leave him alone. He doesn't want to know.
Surely Robbie explained.
Yeah, of course he did, yeah. You were drunk and lonely and wanted some fun. Now go home before I call your husband.
That's what you told him, is it?
Tash, wait!
You git! And you believed him.
I'm gonna go to bed. What's going on?
That's a woman in love, not a woman who's had a one-night stand. It's been going on for months.
Well, well, well. Better be good news.
If we beat Arsenal, your job's safe. We have to win. If we lose or draw, he'll sack you.
Is that the best you can do? You can't have been very good in bed. Perhaps you're with the wrong man.
You should be thanking me.
What for? Saving your neck? You didn't do this for me, Jackie.
You're damn right I didn't. Just make sure that we win.
Don't you dare. You idiots.
No, who cares? I'm not playing.
You might be, you're on the bench.
I'm only here because of you anyway, aren't I? So it doesn't matter what I do.
Right, I'm gonna have some words about this, and by the time I get back, I want you in bed with the lights out. Oi, where do you think you're going? Back to my room, Stuart, is the answer I'm looking for.
Please, Stu, just give us an hour. It's really important.
Nothing is more important than tomorrow's match. What is wrong with you lot? Now get!
Fletch!
I ought to kill you, you lying piece of...
Whoa!
You told me it was a one-night stand. Now I find out you're breaking her heart.
It's not like that.
And you've caused grief between me and Abby.
I'm sorry. I didn't know what to say. Me and Tash, it's complicated.
Nah, it ain't. She's married, her husband comes back in 3 weeks, and you won't be around when he does.
What?
Because you'll be putting in for a transfer request. Won't you?
Where are you going?
To see my wife.
Supposed to clear out all the minibars. How many times have we stayed here?
Well, I'm sorry, sir. I just can't understand how we've missed your room.
I don't care. I just want you to make sure that it won't happen again.
Okay, I'll get on to housekeeping for you.
And you better make sure the rest of the rooms are checked immediately.
I will.
You didn't punch Robbie's other eye, did you?
Don't worry. I was very restrained.
Mm-hmm.
You'd never cheat on me, would you?
Don't be silly.
Even if I was in hospital.
Have you forgotten where we met? I seem to recall there was plenty of opportunity for naughtiness.
In the laundry?
In the staff room? The back of an ambulance?
You asleep?
There you go, darling. We don't need anybody else, do we, eh?
This room is as white as ghosts. In this space you can see your own breath. This room is as cold as toast. Is it this sleep that is the
The Full House signs are up today at the Dragon's Lair. Defending champions Arsenal are visitors. Harchester in need of an improvement in form, but what better way to lift their season than with a victory over Arsene Wenger's side?
It's rubbish. No one believes that.
Someone does. Is this your doing? Invite them in. I don't like the copy, Stuart. Right, lads. I hope you're up for this.
Hello, I'd like to check the ETA of flight number V009 from Los Angeles, please. It's on time. Thank you.
The editor tape for tonight?
Good. You can go now, then.
What about my references?
If I have time.
See, our manager's still in place?
Yeah, but only if we win. What's the news with Hullet?
Got it in hand.
You got time for another drink?
Nah, got to get to the airport. His plane lands in an hour.
What?
We can win this. Contain them. Frustrate them. Draw them on, and then we hit them on the break. We can win this, but we must win it.
Come on, lads. Let's win this game. Come on, come on, come on.
Tension around the Dragon's Lair Stadium today, and could this prove to be a pivotal match in Harchester's season? Let's take a look at manager Patrick Doyle's starting 11. It looks pretty defensive. Marcel Sabatier at the heart of midfield, but look for him pushing left. Mills and Thompson in defence. Defensive field two in midfield with Mack and Grant. And despite some very indifferent form earlier on this season, there's a return for Robbie Walsh in midfield, with Ryan Naismith dropped to the substitutes bench. So it will be Arsenal to get the match underway, and if there's pressure on the players, a defeat today for Harchester could cost that man his job. Here's Toure. Skips past Robbie Walsh. Options left and right here, Toure. Ashley Cole now for Arsenal. Will toward a little bit of space. Oh, and Danny Potter spilled it. It's in by Toure. But the flag is up against Arsenal. For the obvious relief of Patrick Doyle. Such an important match for the manager today. Patrick Vieira, Ray Parlour, several of the Arsenal players, and Arsene Wenger arguing with the fourth official there, Jeff Winter. And a rueful shake of the head from Robbie Walsh. He got lucky. Really has been all Arsenal.
Baggage from flight V009, recently arrived in Los Angeles, is now on the board of Carousel 4.
It's Toure with the Arsenal throw, back with Ashley Cole. One-way traffic still towards the Harchester goal, and Kolo Toure here has been a real threat down the left side. His shot held by Danny Potter. The tactics not working for Patrick Doyle. Wenger much the happier of the managers.
Where are you going?
I can't bear to watch anymore.
Spoken like a true fan.
Vieira has been elegant in the Arsenal midfield today. Parlour getting a touch, another sweeping move from Arsenal. Harchester really being stretched again here now. That's a superb tackle by Stuart Naismith. Half-time whistle, Patrick Doyle will be happy to hear that. His side have been under so much pressure from the reigning champions. And in all honesty, Harchester are lucky to be on terms. It's 0-0 at half-time.
I said we had to win this. All I can see in here are a bunch of losers. Losers! You? Why did you bother turning up today? Go and get showered and changed, you're off. Get out of my sight. Ryan, you're on. We play five across the midfield. You and Grant, you'll be acting as wingbacks. Stuart, move up next to Ryan. Curtis, Fletch, a word.
your tactics. I always thought that was the right way to play them.
You're right. Just remember what we did in training, son.
Leave me alone.
Listen, I need you out there, Ryan. I'm counting on you to get that ball. You have got the skill, now show me you've got the nerve.
What if I haven't?
You have. Just play as you did yesterday, and we'll keep this lot a game. Yeah?
Come on. Please, boss.
If I didn't have reason to sack you before, I've got ample now. Theft, vandalism, I should call the police.
Go ahead. I'll tell them you drove me to it.
And they'll take the word of a drunken bimbo. Take that. Think of it as a leaving present.
Now listen to me, listen to me. This is it. Make or break. Now, if we win, we show that lot out there we're back. If we lose, it doesn't bear thinking about it. Now, I know you can win, because I believe you can win, but do you believe you can win? Eh? Do you? Right. Do you believe you can beat the Arsenal?
Yes. Yes.
What?
Yes!
Well, go and do it then.
Come on!
Manager Patrick Doyle simply had to make a switch at half-time and bringing on Ryan Naismith for the disappointing Robbie Walsh in that galvanised Harchester into a better performance. Long ball from Sullivan, Sabatier causing problems for Big Sol Campbell, but the defending was very good from the England international. But this is much better from Harchester.
What are you doing? You should be on the bench by now.
I don't need you having a go at me as well.
Just hurry up.
I thought I was doing the right thing, you know. Telling Fletch what I did.
Lying's never the right thing.
I was just trying to protect myself. And Tash.
What are you telling me for? I'm not the one you've hurt.
Well, maybe I shouldn't go on the bench.
What are you talking about?
Maybe I should go home. And rest my leg.
There's nothing wrong with your leg.
Bobby Thompson. Mack making a good run forward, getting in behind the Arsenal defence here. Oh, it gets beyond Sabatier, and this is Fletcher! Quite easily the best chance Harchester have had so far. But the game plan seems to be working now for Patrick Doyle. That's what he wants more of. And what a turnaround at the start of this second half.
Tash. Tash, let me in. Look, I'm not going to let me explain. Oh, come on.
Sullivan is wide. Can he get his cross in?
I had to say what I did. I had to protect myself.
What, by passing me off as a bored housewife? Some bored, easy lay that lured you into bed for kicks?
I didn't mean it, Tash.
Yes, you did. Do you know, I spent all last night thinking, how could he say that? And then I worked it out. You're just a typical bloke, Robbie. Desperate for me when you can't have me, and then as soon as you've got me, you don't want me anymore.
How can you say that? How can you possibly think I don't want you?
Because if you did, you'd have told Fletch the truth. No matter what the consequences.
I know. I was a coward. But not anymore, Tash. I promise. I love you. And if you want me to, I'll tell everyone. I'll go on TV. I'll call the papers.
Probably not a good idea.
Here's Mack. A little bit of space in midfield now. And a foul by Vieira. Something a little anxious now. Chester very much in the ascendancy. Sabatier over the free kick. Into the heart of the area. But Harchester have turned this game on its head. And a very timely goal indeed.
flat.
What a cracking second half he's had, coming on at the break for the disappointing Walsh. They're queuing up for the cross here. Arsenal stretched again. And what a finish to the Maxim Harchester. Final kick from Peter Mack. It's all over. Patrick Doyle's job looks more secure now. The fans absolutely delighted. You can see what it means to the players. Martin Keown disappointed for Arsenal. But what a contrast to their opening half performance. It was Harchester at their very best in the second half. And what a fillip to their season. They've beaten the reigning champions, Arsenal, 1-0.
Hey! Great strike, French boy.
I would have done better, but...
Lads, I think a toast to our coach. Your tactics, boss.
Cheers.
Those half-time changes, pure genius.
Congratulations, Mr. Chairman. Let's make sure it's the first of many.
Way to go, boys. And what about our young hero here?
Yes. He wasn't bad.
Well done.
Nicky, have you seen Jackie?
No. Nor Tara.
Oh, you idiot, Tara.
After getting us both off the hook, I want to celebrate.
Well, I don't feel like it.
I do.
You must be joking.
Jackie, I may have kept my job. Doesn't mean I have to keep my mouth shut.
But we had an agreement.
I've changed the terms.
I'll scream. I'll break the door down.
You don't have to. You can go. And all I have to do is pick up the phone, call your husband, and ask him if he's missing anything. Well, that's mine. Just like you are.
Don't you believe it? They need you more than ever. And they're not the only ones. Thanks for coming back.
Well, it's good to be back.
What?
I think I just heard my dad's car.
So what? Don't let him in.
He's got a key.
We've been here before, haven't we?
Quick, Robbie.
I forgot the back door this time.
Oh. No, through the kitchen. Robbie!
It's locked. Where's the key? Quick!
God, I don't know.
Hi, Dad.
You all right?
Yeah, it's just exercising.
Have I got a surprise for you?
Hey, babes.
Coming soon on Dream Team.
Tash, you have to tell him. Or I will.
Fletch, if there was anything, you know, you would tell me about it, wouldn't you?
Yeah, of course we'd, mate, yeah.
Don't you know what they do under mistletoe?
I can take a guess.
Don't just guess.
Come to Papa.
Oi, lads, I think the gaffer wants to get stuck in.
I can still show you lot a thing or two.
I think I'm going to be around for a good while, yeah? So don't get on my bad side.
I spoke again with Rude Holly.
Great. Let's do it.
Leave it to me.
The Planet Express faces competition from a rival company started up by Dwight and Cubert in the first of a Futurama double tonight at 8 here on Sky 3.